Well, it's after Halloween, which means that for an absurdly high percentage of the population, it's the Christmas season. Now, if I can tell you a cold, dark secret of mine, I'm really not that big into Christmas. It's not that I'm the Grinch, per se. I like Christmas. I just don't really have any interest in celebrating it for 8 weeks. And maybe the reason I feel that way is partially because of something that happened to me when I was a kid. It was a bad Christmas season experience. So, see, when I was a kid, I grew up an only child, and not only that, but my mom's siblings, they never had any kids of their own, so I was not only an only child, but I was basically the only child in, like, the whole family. And so that means that I grew up getting pretty much anything I wanted every Christmas. Well, one year when I was, I don't know, maybe I was around six, something like that, it's Christmas morning or whatever, and the entire extended family is sitting around the living room and they're watching their cherished bundle of sunshine, that's me, open all of the Christmas gifts. But honestly, like, for whatever reason, after I opened up that last gift and looked around me and realized that there were no more gifts to open, I mean, I was shocked. Like, I mean, I had been opening presents for literally like 30 minutes straight. I got everything on my Christmas list, but for some reason, six-year-old Mike was absolutely dumbfounded that there weren't more gifts under the tree for me. So I said the one thing that you should never say on Christmas morning in front of your entire family. What is that it? By the way everyone reacted, you would have thought I said a cuss word. But before you judge me, I think you can probably resonate with six-year-old Mike more than you might think. Like, maybe it's part of our culture, maybe it's just part of growing up, maybe it's even just kind of tied to who you are individually and the way that you're wired, but I think a lot of us easily forget about the good gifts that we've received in the past, and we just sort of expect more. Right, when problems in our lives are resolved or tests are passed or auditions are aced, right, it's easy to sort of let go of that and find something new to stress about or to complain about or to expectantly wait for. And there's nothing necessarily wrong with that, right? I mean, it's good to look forward. It's good to press ahead to what's next in life. It's good to keep your eyes on what God might be doing in your future. But I think sometimes when we don't spend enough time looking back, we sort of wind up like six-year-old Mike whining on the living room floor, surrounded by evidence of God's faithfulness and love for you, but discontent because we can't see more good things coming yet. So look, it's November. I mean, there's tons of stuff that you're probably stressing about right now. I mean, we just had an election, and about half the country is pretty upset about the results. So depending on who your household supported and how passionate they are about politics, that might be a stress factor in your life right now. And you're looking to God expectantly like, what's next? You know, the school year has been one of the most weird and difficult, like, ever. And you still have at least a few months before you get to go back in person. And even then, who knows what that's going to be like? So yeah, maybe that's something you're seeing in front of you and you're looking to God expectantly like, what's next? You know, COVID restrictions have been hard on all of us, but like, at least it was warm outside before. We're about to head into winter where it's cold and dark and even in normal years, that cold and dark season, right, that has some effects on mental health. So maybe that's something you're seeing in front of you and you're looking to God expectantly like, what's next? Now, here's the deal. All of that is legitimate stuff to have weighing on your heart and on your mind. And I'm sure there's a whole lot of stuff weighing on you that I haven't even mentioned. But what I'm hoping we can do today is just pause for a minute and appreciate what God has done. And I think taking a moment to appreciate the unwrapped pile of Christmas gifts lying around us, I think that's going to help us feel a little bit more at peace as we look forward to what's next. So if you've been with us for a while, you probably know about Paul. We talk about him all the time in MSU and HSU. And the thing about Paul is, dude had a lot going on. Nobody understood the pressure of, like, what's next more than Paul. He was always thinking about the next region that needed a church planted. He always knew that there were groups out there that wanted to torture him and to throw him in jail. And he always knew that problems were going to come and things weren't going to be smooth. And he was going to have to find ways to persevere through it. And yet through it all, Paul had joy. He had contentment. He had peace. And so when he writes to the Thessalonians, we should listen to what he has to say. We're in 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Super simple. Here's the verse. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. And look, it isn't the most complex verse in the Bible, but it's pretty powerful. That no matter what you're going through, no matter what you're looking forward to, no matter what feels like it's pressing in on you, give thanks. Be thankful. Look down at the pile of good gifts given to you from God and be thankful. Look back at the trail of God's faithfulness in your life up to this point and be thankful. But Paul isn't saying to pretend like God has made your life perfect up until this point. We all know your life hasn't been perfect up until this point. You've had to go through hard things. Paul gets that. Paul had to go through hard things too. So he's not saying that you have to pretend like, oh God, thank you that you've made everything perfect up until now. Like, no, we know that that's not the case. But when it feels like the whole country is going nuts and school is way harder than it used to be and you're going to be trapped indoors for the next 4 months and you're not sure how in the world you're going to be able to handle it all. Give thanks. So what are the Christmas gifts piled at your feet that you're ignoring? You know, what are the things that God has done in your life and in your heart over the past few years that you've sort of forgotten about? If you journal, maybe you should take some time over the next week to just look through the past journals and kind of help you remember where God has brought you from. And if you don't journal, then maybe you should just commit to spending 30 minutes in silence over the next week, just reflecting on what you can be thankful for. Man, this is what God wants for you in Christ. And I think if you'll just give it a real shot, I think you'll discover that this is what you want for yourself too. Things are crazy. They're crazy right now, and life is not always easy, but give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. We'll see you later.